Saindhava Ghanavat, these are the illustrations that are given. This comes on the fourth Brahmana of the same chapter. Saindhava Ghanavat. There it is said, how like a mass of, like a little particle of salt when it goes into the, in fact, Saindhava Ghana, example comes later on, 4, 5, 13, you know, in the fourth chapter. So that's where Atma is described as Saindhava Ghana. Like Saindhava Ghana. Like a mass of salt. So how, whatever be the reason why that example is given, but apparently there is no space, no visible space between the particles of salt. So there is a lump, a dense lump of salt. Apparently a lump of salt must communicate the idea of denseness. Ekarsatvam, homogeneity. There is nothing to separate the two particles of salt in a dense lump of salt. And how there is effort, what prevails there is just oneness, ekarasatvam, homogeneity or oneness that prevails there. And similarly also, there is no separation at all between Jiva and Brahma, that oneness prevails. For that the Saindhava Ghana example is given. Then prajnapti ekarasatvam is vijnana ghanatvam. Vijnana ghana eva, that's what is said in the 2.4.12, vijnana ghana. And that also it is said. This Vijnana Ghana is said in more than one places. He is nothing but the Ghana, again, a mass of the dense mass of consciousness, meaning this pure consciousness. Then, Ekarasa, Prajnapti Ekarasa, Nairantariya is Anantaram Abhakhyam. This is how Nairantariya is being said. Anantaram Abhakhyam, Bhakhyantara Bhedrahitam. There is no innerness, outerness in Brahma. Avadharana. So there is an emphasis, an emphasis or firmness, that is where that he is Prajnana Ghana Eva, Saindhava Ghana Eva, Anantaram Avahyam Anaparam. Eka Dhaiva Anudrashtavyam, meaning Eka Rupena Eva Anudrashtavyam. Brahma was seen as one also. Iti cha Avadharana. Anandagiri says, Chakarha avadharanadi padam anukarshati iti cha avadharanat. Also, all this avadharana meaning emphasis. So, emphasis that is given to ekada eva anudashtavyam. Ekada eva, that eva kara is there. That Brahman must be seen as one alone. That's called avadharanam. He saindhavaganavat eva. Like saindhavagana, vijnanaghana, anantaram, anaparam, abhakhyam. In all of these, very clearly says that this is that evakara, that emphasis shows that that is where the importance is laid by Shruti, and not in this duality. So that's another reason why we have to say that the tatparya part of the Shruti could not be in giving, communicating reality to duality. It must be only in communicating the reality to of oneness. Sangrahitam artham vivranoti. So what is said briefly again in this vakya is explained in detail in the next sentence. Yadicha. Yadicha brahmanah chitrapatavat vruksha samudradi vatcha utpatyadi aneka dharma vichitrata vijigrahayishita ekarasam saindhava ghanavata anantaram avakhyamidina uide na upasamharisheta ekadhaivanudrashtavyamide cha na prayokshyata yaih naneva pashyate idi nindavachanam cha. Yadi cha brahmanah chitrapatavat. Chitrapat means a painting. On the chitpata, on the cloth, you make chitra. So, on the cloth, you make a chitra or a painting. Vruksha samudradi vachya. Oh, chitravat patavat, but chitrapata. So, how there is variegated, you know, forms, etc. on a painting. Vrukshavat, like in tree also there are so many branches and whatever, so many variety, multiplicity is there. Samudradivacha, in Samudra they find the ocean, how so many waves are there. So these are examples that are given actually. Utpatyadi aneka dharma vichitrata vijigrahishita grahekumishta. If it is desired by the Shruti, then the student should actually vijigrahayatu, meaning that they should actually grasp only the duality. Aneka dharma vichitrata grahayatum ishta, jigrahayatum ishta. It was desirable that the student should actually acquire or understand that the duality is real, if this was the idea. Then, ekarasam saindavaganavat. So, all of this would not have been stated. So, na prayokshava. These expressions would not have been used there. Saindavaganavat, that it is one homogeneous, anantaram abhahyam, without antara, without innerness, outerness, itina upasamharishet. This kind of upasamhara or the conclusion would not have been there. Ekadhevanu drashtam iti jana prayokshada, and that Brahman must be seen as one alone. Naturally, why is it to be said that? If Brahman was one, and if Brahman was evidently one, there was no need to say that. Brahman is one but appears to be many, therefore it is being said that it must be seen as one. Had it been appearing as one, nobody had to say that. Ishavasyavidam sarvam, all of these must be perceived as Ishvara. If it appears to be Ishvara, we need not be told. It appears to be an Ishvara, therefore we have to be told that all of these must be perceived as Ishvara. And similarly, all of these appears to be multiple, therefore we are told ekadhaivanu drashtavyam, that it must be seen as one alone. Iti cha na prayokshara. So all of these would need, see footnote number 2 on page 502. Yad vachana bhyadam ityadi vang manas ati tattva pratipadaka vachana samuchyartha chakarah yato vacho nivartante aprapya manasasah yad vachana bhyadam yena vag bhyadate yan manasana manude yena ahur manomatam. So all these are the statements from Keno Upanishad. So that which cannot be revealed by the speech, but because of it the speech reveals. Ityadi vang manas ati tattva pratipadaka vachana samuchyartha chakarah. So elsewhere also Brahman is being said to be that which is beyond the mind and the speech. Tathāca samudra tarangādeheva brahmajñāpake sṛṣṭivākye brahmana vastutah amshāṁśitvādi iṣṭam cet tadātasya vāṅg manasādītattvam advitītvam ca tātpariyena śrutihi na bruyāt saviśeṣasya tadviṣayatvāditya. Tathāca, thus, samudra tarangādeheva, like the waves of the ocean. Brahmajñāpake sṛṣṭivākye. So the sṛṣṭivākya are the passages dealing with creation, which are really meant only to convey the nature of Brahman. Even naturally, because Upanishad is only committed to one subject matter, that is Brahman. So whatever is being said in Upanishad is said in order to convey the nature of Brahman, including sṛṣṭi of the creation. So all these passages which describe the creation, whose purport or the purpose is to communicate the true nature of Brahma. Suppose through these Shruti passages, Sṛṣṭi passages, Brahma jñāpake Sṛṣṭi vākye, Brahmanah vastutah amsham shitvāda iṣṭam chet. If Shruti meant to say that, in fact, the creation is a vikāra or modification of Brahma, or jīva is amsha or a fraction of Brahman, if that was what was meant to be said by through those illustrations, tadātasya vāṅg manasa atītattvam advidiyattvam ca tātpariyena śrutihi na bruyāt, then there is no need for the śruti to say that Brahman is beyond words and the mind, or advidiyattvam ca, or that Brahman is one without a second, ekameva advitiyam iti tātpariyena śrutihi na bruyāt, śruti would not have said that. Why? Savisheshtasya tadvishetvaditya. Because duality is within the realm of speech and the mind. So the duality, that I am separate from Brahman, that truth, is something that is within the scope of the words and the mind, whereas Shruti says that Brahman is beyond the scope of words and mind. So that means that what is within the scope of words and mind is not truly Brahman. But Brahman is that which is beyond that. And what is within the scope is his duality. Meaning thereby the duality is not the true nature of Brahman, it is mithya. But otherwise if what we see were true, then there would have been no need for us to say that Brahman is beyond the words and the mind, because what is within the words and mind is duality, and Brahman is beyond duality. So all of this also very clearly says that the purport of the Upanishad is not in communicating duality, is in communicating oneness alone. Yeha nanayo pashyati nindavacanam cha mrityo smrityum gacchati. Yeha nanayo pashyati goes from death to death. The one who sees the duality here in Brahman goes from one death to another death. Idi cha nindavacanam cha na prayokshareti sambandha. That also Shruti would not have said. The duality also is condemned. Not duality really, but then this dvaita darshanam, giving reality to duality is condemned. Duality is a vyavaharik satta. There is nothing wrong or right about it. That's what it is. But to take the duality to be real, that is what is condemned. Mrityo sumrityum gacchati yeha naneva pashyati. One who sees as though duality goes from death to death. Meaning one who gives reality to duality goes from death to death. Dvaita darshanam, that is which is condemned there. So now we are on the page, I think on page 501 we have seen all the basically footnotes. You know. Going to page 502 now. Sri Ramanagiri, Ekatvasya Avadharana Phalamaha. This is footnote number 12 there. Ekatva Avadharana Meva Phalam. Visvalingadhyasthana shrutina mityartha. With all these shrutis, these illustrations of visvalinga etc., their phala is what? Ekatva dharanam. To in fact create a conviction about oneness is the purpose of these illustrations. So Anandagiri says, ekatvasya avadharana phalatvam. That means that ekatva is the phalam, is the result of avadharanam. Or ekatvasya avadharana phalam. The result of emphasizing oneness is being said tasmadiri, says Bhashyakara. Tasmad ekarupa ekatva pratyadardhyaya eva sarva vedanteshu utpatti sthitilayadi kalpana natat pratyakaranaya. Tasmad, therefore, ekarupa ekatva pratyadardhyaya eva, only for pratyadardhyam, for creating this firm conviction of ekarupa, ekatva. See footnote number 4. Tasmad, ukta aneka vakya virodhena srishtyadi vakyanam swadhi tatpare bhava avadharanat. So srishti vakyas are there, but if we say that srishti vakyas only communicate duality, then they contradict so many other vakyas. So ukta aneka vakya virodhena, so that creation which appears to communicate duality contradicts so many other statements of Upanishad. Therefore we say that swarthe, those people who say that Upanishad does not have tatpari in oneness, because it contradicts Shruti vakya. We say Upanishad does not have tatpari in srishti because it contradicts one vakya of oneness. Those people who say Upanishad does not have tatpari in oneness because it contradicts the srishti vakya, which becomes important for you. But here upakrama, upasamhara, in both the places there is oneness. Ukta aneka vakya virodhena srishtyadi vakyanam swarthe tatpari abhava avadharanat. And so that Upanishad does not have the tatpari, the purport in communicating reality of the srishti. Therefore, ekarupa ekatva aham brahma iti evam abheda nischaya. So aham brahma iti pratyadardhyaya eva, for that conviction I am brahma. Sarva vedanteshu utpatti sthiti laya adi kalpana, all this kalpana, utpatti sthiti laya etc., all this kalpana, even this, if these things are not scientifically accurate, doesn't matter. The idea is that it is not important whether the description of creation, etc., are scientifically accurate, because all that kalpana is being said for what? Mainly the purport is to communicate oneness. Whether there was a king and then whether the prince was kidnapped and stuff like this is not important. Whether such a thing really happened or not is not so important. What is important is what it conveys, namely that he was prince and not the son of a butcher. So sarvedan deshu utpatti sthiti layadi kalpana. Layadi. So utpatti sthiti laya yato vayamani bhutani jayante yena jatani jivanti yat prayanti abhisamvishanti. So laya and then becoming one and then again arising. All this kalpana, and then pravesha and niyamana, as Anandagiri will say, natat pratyekaranaya. It is not to say that Brahman actually got separated, actually thought, actually became many, actually entered, actually did all this. That is not the idea there. Natat nischaya utpadanaya. This is very bold. To say this about the Shruti, that this is where, that is not the tatparya there, is something very bold, because the passages dealing with creation occupy a lot of room. More perhaps, you know, there are more statements, the lender passages dealing with creation than dealing with this Mahavakyas. And therefore to come up with this requires a tremendous amount of boldness to see what is the overall purpose. That's where of course Vashya can also refer to the earlier Acharyas. This is what actually is the, what we find in the Mandukya Karika. That's why the Karikara says, Manulloho Visfulingadi. So, Srishti Chodhita. Huh? Yeah, Srishtiya Chodhita Anyatha. All this Srishti that is being said, and that is the tatpari only in oneness and not in the creation. So, of course, that's a traditional teaching that is coming down to us. But the point is that is where the tatpari is not. The tatpari is in oneness alone. एकत्वस्य भेदः सो तस्मात् एकरूप एकत्व प्रत्यय. एकत्व इज आल्सो डिफरेंट काइंड्स. एकत्व वननेस कैन बी ऑफ डिफरेंट काइंड्स. सो एकरूप एकत्व होमोजीनियस वननेस, वननेस दैट डज नॉट एक्चुअली टॉलरेट एनी काइंड ऑफ ए ड्युअलिटी. एकत्वस्य भेद सहत्वं वारयितुं, देयर कैन बी काइंड ऑफ वननेस दैट आल्सो टॉलरेट्स ड्युअलिटी. एकरूप विशेषणम, सी फुटनोट नंबर 13. एकत्वस्य भेद सहत्वमिति तादात्म्य रूपत्वम इत्यर्थः. फॉर एग्जांपल द आयरन एंड फायर. सो व्हेन द फायर आयरन इज हीटेड इन द फायर, देन देयर इज वननेस विद आयरन एंड फायर. दैट इज कॉल्ड भेद सहिष्णुः अभेदस्य तादात्म्यत्वम्. भेद सहिष्णुः अभेदस्य, अभेद और वननेस that actually tolerates the bheda. Even though the iron and fire are one, still they are separate. Iron has not become fire, fire has not become iron, iron is not fire, fire is not iron, they are one and still separate. So this is what? Bheda sahishnuhu abhedaha. A bheda or the oneness that actually has in its womb the separation of the duality. So oneness having duality in its womb, oneness in spite of duality, oneness that is concurrent with the duality. Says kinchid rupena bheda, kinchid rupena abhedaha. So abhedaha in one way and bheda in another way. That kind of abheda. So amshamshi, all of this is bheda sahishnu abhedaha. When I say that the finger is I, this is finger is nothing but I, it is true from one standpoint that I am there in the finger. At the same time, the finger is not I. So when they say that Jiva is an amsha of Paramatma, in a way it says that Jiva is Paramatma, because from one standpoint, Jiva being amsha, amsha is never separate from amshi. In that sense, they are one. That's how they interpret Mahavakya. At the same time, they interpret the Srishti Vakya, saying that Jiva is separate from Brahma. That's how they want to accommodate everything. So from the standpoint of the cause, if there is oneness, the statement of the effect, there is multiplicity. It says, no, ekarupa ekatva pratyaya. Ekarupa ekatva, meaning homogeneous oneness. It's not that there is oneness which has in its womb the duality. That homogeneous oneness alone is the purpose. So Saindava Ghana, Vijnana Ghana, all these illustrations are given. Or Vashyakara brings those illustrations here. Ghana means a mass. Leaves no room at all between the particles and the total homogeneous oneness. So varaitum meaning bheda bheda apanutyartham. There's no bheda bheda. Bheda as well as abheda. This argument was made earlier. Then why not we say that there is bheda as well as abheda? That will explain everything. But then lot of ridiculousness was pointed out with reference to that. And therefore, to communicate bheda bheda is not the purport of the Shruti. Then says Anandagiri, Adishabdena Pravesha Niyamane Grihyade. So Utpatti Sthiti Layadi Kalpana, Adishabdena Pravesha Tasrushtva Tadevanu Pravishada. Utpatti Sthiti Laya is said in many places. Yatova Imani Bhutani Jayante Yena Jatani Jivandi Yat Prendi Abhisam Vishandi. From that from which the whole creation is born, by which it is sustained, unto which it goes back and becomes one. So that is Utpatti Sthiti Laya. That's one kalpana. Then Adishabdena Pravesha. Tat Srushtva Tadevanu Pravishada. Having created these names and forms, he entered as their very self. Anena Jivena Atmana Anupravishya Namrupa Vyakarvani. I'll enter as their self. And then they will expand in the names and forms. This is the Pravesha Shruti. There is also Kalpana. Meaning, there is also a story. Niyamane Niyama. That is a Niyanta. Say Bhudharanika. Yasya Prithvi Shariram. Yo Prithvi Mantara Yamayati. Eshade Atma Antaryami Amrutaha. So Yasya Prithvi Shariram. The one for whom this Prithvi of the earth is a body. Yeh Prithvi Mantara. One is within the earth. So one for whom the earth is a body. One is within the earth, and remaining within, one who controls, that is your very self, that is immortal. All of these, that he is a Niyamaka, all of these are the, says, all this Kalpana. That means all of this is Arthavada. Arthavada means what? Either Stuti or Ninda, all these kind of stories that are being told, Arthavada does not have Tatparya in itself, Arthavada is Tatparya in something else. Arthavada is not the major statement. It is a statement which is avantara tatpare is in Mahavakya. In short, all this creation, sustenance, dissolution, entry, and becoming many, and being the ruler, all of these have the tatpariya in only communicating the total oneness between Jiva and Brahma.
Natat pratyaya karanaya iti yatra tat shabdena utpatyad bhedha vivakshitaha. Natat Pratyekarana, as Vashyakara said. Natat Pratyekarana means Tat Shabdena. No, Utpatyadi Bheda Pratyekaranaya. That's what the footnote number 14 said. For that, this is not to communicate the Bheda or the Bheda Bheda, but to communicate only absolute oneness. Okay, we'll continue tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmeti Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namah Hari Om.
Ekatva Pratyadardhyaya
सुवर्णमयलोहाग्नि विस्फलिंग दृष्टान्ताः उत्पत्यादि भेद प्रतिपादन पराः.
Therefore, all this drishtanta, the description that the Upanishads gave pertaining to the creation, and to explain the nature of the creation, the illustrations that are given of the clay or the gold or the fire.
Ekattva pratyedarthyaya.
That is, in fact, to make firm the conviction about total oneness or unity that is underlying all the diversity.
Notpatyadi bheda pratipadana paraha.
There is no intention on the part of the Shruti to give reality to the bheda, the duality or division that is perceptible. On the other hand, the Shruti says that in spite of apparent division, that there is an undivided and indivisible entity, reality, and to teach that is the purpose of all these the descriptions of creation, and the various illustrations are so chosen. In fact, the illustrations are so chosen as to convey that oneness. As it was said, how even the example of this fire and the sparks shows
prag agnehe bhamshat agni ekatva darshanat visvalingasya.
The spark also was one with fire, was fire alone before it split out from the fire. So it is that which is what is meant. Sadeva somye idamagrasit ekamevadvityam. This is how the Upanishad begins, that all this universe before its creation was Brahman, one without a second, like fire. And tathaksharad vidasumya bhavah prajayante tatra chaivabhyanti. And so then, from akshara, this purushottama paramatma, how different beings emerge or split out, like the sparks splitting out from the fire. And meaning that they are one, and the splitting is only apparent. Splitting is actually mithya, and the oneness is satyam. So they think that the splitting or the duality is satya, and there is no more non-duality. How can it be? That which is non-dual has to be undivided, indivisible, and that which is indivisible cannot be divided. Therefore, the divisions have to be apparent or unreal. And so, this is how, as Vashyakara said, had it been the intention of the Shruti to convey this duality or division, there was no reason for the Shruti to give, they use the expressions saindhava ghana, vijnana ghana. These expressions would not be used. A mass of consciousness, saindhava ghana, homogeneous, one mass, undivided. And also anantaram avakhyam, that which is devoid of the idea of the outside and inside. Also the ninda that is done also. Mrityosa mrityam gacchati yeha naneva pashyati. Someone who sees a duality or gives reality to duality goes from death to death. All these, thus the condemnation of the duality also is found. All of this was not necessary. Had it been the intention of the Shruti to say that what the duality that we perceive is a reality, if this is the intention, there would have been no need to do this.
Tasmad eka rupa ekatva pratyedarthyaya.
And also the ekatva, the oneness, does not involve any kind of a contact or relationship. There is no samsarga and there is no vishishtata either. It is not that the jiva is a part of Brahma, related to Brahma, conditioned. In some way or the other you can imagine variety of relationships. Within Brahma, part of Brahma, subservient to Brahma, or whatever. Swami always used to ask this question, what is the relationship between the water and the wave? Is the water behind the wave, under the wave? Where is the water? What's the relationship between the water and the wave? So when you think of that, we find that the wave is water. Therefore, there is no relationship. There is a contact between them. The wave is on the water. That kind of relationship is not there. Or the wave belongs to water. Or wave is subservient to water. All of these idea of belonging, being subservient, all of these come when the wave takes itself to be different from water. And takes itself merely to be confined to wave, then all these ideas are there.
Tasmat ekarupa ekatva pratyedarthyaya eva sarva vedanteshu utpatti sthiti layadi kalpana.
And thus, in all the Vedantas, when utpatti, sthiti, laya, pravesha, niyamanam, he is antaryami, antasam yamayati, remaining inside, remaining within, he controls everything. Thus, God is presented as a controller. He is presented as the one who has entered this upadhi. He is presented as one who is a creator, sustainer, dissolver. All of these are the kalpanas. All the other ideas that are really superimposed upon Brahman, because there is a need of the part of the human being to get an explanation for all this. Because I see a universe in front of me, there is a need on my part to know where did the universe come from, who created it. That's how the first concept of God is, the one who has created the universe, which is fine. But the creation cannot be real because the universe is also not real. And so, it is not to create the conviction of the divided division that this is given. It is in fact to create the conviction about and the firm conviction about the non-dual, that these illustrations and all these kalpanas are there. All the kalpanas. He created an entity. They are all stories. It's like Puranic stories sometimes Upanishad tells. So kamayada bahusyam prajayeti. He desired, may I become many? Satapotapyada. He performed penance. Satapastaptva, having performed the penance, idagum sarvam asrujata, he created all this. So this is all story. And so, based on statements like this in Puranas, we find elaborate stories of how God created, how Brahmaji appeared as a very embodiment of desire. And how then the tapasya was performed, and how Brahmaji saw the whole universe in front of him, and how he created. So, this kind of passages actually form the basis for many elaborate stories. All this kalpana is for only one thing, to convey the truth that all there is oneness or unity. We are now on page 502. Says Anandagiri in second paragraph, third line. Kincha parasya ekadeshah vijnanatma ityatra tadekadeshah swabhaviko va syat upadhiko va iti vikalpya. Kincha, furthermore, see footnote number 16. There is an objection involved here. Nanu shastrasya amsham amsha amshitvado atatpariyat tadvashat tadkalpana mabhut. Okay. So here Mahasyakara said that the purpose of giving the illustration of fire and sparks is not in any way to convey the idea of amsha and the amshi, that the spark is amsha and the fire is amshi, and similarly jiva is amsha and Brahma is amshi, possessed of the amsha. That is not the idea. Says nanu shastrasya amsha amshitvado atatparya. If Shastra does not have tatparya in conveying this kind of relationship between jiva and Brahma, tadvashat tad kalpana mabhut. You are saying that all this utpatti sthiti layadi kalpana, this kalpana, what for is it? The Purupakshi says, all right, maybe it is not to convey the amsha amshitva relationship between jiva and Brahma. But upadanasya mrudadehe savayavattva drishtehe. But it is said that Brahma is upadana karana, material cause of the creation. Savayavattva drishtehe. And we know that wherever there is a material cause is a composite entity. Like clay is a composite entity. Then alone you can modify it, otherwise you cannot modify it. So avayava means various ingredients are there, various components are there, of which this aggregate is made. So a substance like clay is an aggregate made up of different components or having different qualities, making it available to be formed and modified. So upadanasya mrudadehe savayavattva drishtehe brahmanopi jagadupadanataya tathatvam. So we say that Brahma also is the jagadupadanam, is the material cause of creation, because Brahman is presented as the efficient as well as material cause. Tathatvam savayavattvam, that Brahma being the material cause of the creation must be savayava, meaning possessed of avayava, possessed of ingredients or components or limbs. Ityadi nyayastu bhavishyanti iti ashankya. So this kind of rules will be applicable if Brahman is the material cause. And so kincha, that is why Anandagiri says kincha. Alright, suppose you say that Brahma is avayava, meaning Brahma has avayavas, Brahma has parts, Brahma has limbs, or Brahma has components. And Jiva is one of the limbs or one of the components of Brahman. Let us see. Kincha parasya ekadesha vijnanatma ityatra. When someone says parasya ekadesha vijnanatma, the Jivatma is ekadesha, a part of para or paramatma. Let us say. So let us explore that idea that Jivatma is an amsha or a part of paramatma. Let us explore that. Ityatra tadekadesha swabhaviko va syat upadhiko va. That ekadeshatvam or that being part of paramatma, swabhavikah, is it something that is inherent in paramatma? That is how the jivatma is split from him. Upadhiko va. Oh, that the idea or this whole appearance of multiplicity has come because of upadhi. Is that manyness, is it something that is inherent in Brahman or Paramatma? That is why there are many jivas. Or that multiplicity is upadhika, because upadhi. Upadhi means what? An extraneous factor which brings about. Like the crystal which is colorless, the flower becomes upadhi, an extraneous factor which brings about the conditioning of the crystal. So it's called a conditioning factor or conditioning adjunct, different names. And so that redness of the crystal is not swabhavika. It's not something that is inherent in crystal. It is upadhika. It is because of the upadhi. Because the extraneous factor of that red flower that the crystal appears red. And so the question here is that there are many jivas. The manyness of the Atma is something that is inherent. Is Atma inherently many, split or divided into many? All that manyness is upadhika, is because of some upadhi. This is a question. Iti vikalpya adhyam dushayati nacha iti. So now the second paragraph, this page 502, second paragraph, second line. Nacha niravayavasya paramatmanah asamsarinah samsaryekadeshakalpana nyaya svatah adeshatvat paramatmanah adeshasya parasya ekadesha samsaritva kalpanayam paraha eva samsare iti kalpitam bhaved. Nacha niravayavasya paramatmanah asamsarinah samsari ekadesha kalpana nyaya. And paramatma is accepted as niravaya by everyone. As niravaya means partless, homogeneous, one, indivisible. Paramatma asamsarinah, even also accept that paramatma is asamsari, is beyond samsara. Uttama purushastu anyah paramatma iti udaharatah yasmat kshramate toham aksharadavi chottamah. This kshara and akshara are within the realm of samsara. He is what? He is beyond kshara and akshara asamsarinah. Someone is beyond samsara. Ekatasya ekadesha kalpana na nyaya. To imagine that paramatma such as that has been divided into many, that kalpana na nyaya, it is not reasonable, not logical, not tenable. Svataha adeshatvat paramatmanah. Svataha. Svataha means inherently paramatma adeshatvat. He is not confined to a given desha, nor is he within the idea of desha. That idea of deshatvam, meaning the idea of place, etc., is not there in paramatma. This question is sometimes Swamiji, you know, when he gives elaborate story about the creation and stuff like that, particularly asking this question, so where was God before you created the world, you know? This is all Christian stuff. And so, he was in heavens before he created the world. God in heavens created the world. But then, who created heaven, Mom? It was God created heaven. Okay. Umam, then where was God before He created heaven? So, when you pursue this line of questioning, then you come to a ridiculous point of saying that God was in hell before He created heaven. And it's all right. But who put God in hell, you know? But the thing is, further, the question of where was God, that arises when? We imagine that this time and space were already there. See, the question of where comes when there is already space. The idea of space is there. That itself is creation. In fact, the whole creation begins with the idea of space and time. And so when we say before creation, before the idea of time and space, there is no question of where. Which of course means that heavens cannot be meant to be a place anyway, which they don't mean also. But the thing is that the question of where is not there, or when is not there, when even the time, the concepts of time and space are not created. Maya kalpita desha kala kalana vaichitra chitrikritam. This desha and kala, all these varieties actually projected by Maya, and by the play of this space and time that we have this variety in this creation. And so the adesha says svatah adeshatvat paramatmanah. So the idea of desha, or the place, or the, you know, the paramatma is confined to a certain space, or that he has a place within himself where he is not, you know. So this kind of, that there is a place where he is not, this kind of thing cannot be na paramatmanah. Adeshatvat means, so avayava abhavat. He doesn't have any avayava of the limbs that you can split him into many. So samsari ekadesha kalpana, meaning he is a samsari. And then ekadesha, that jiva is samsari, and one part of paramatma, who is himself a samsari and partless. So paramatma is partless and a samsari, and jiva is a part of paramatma and samsari. This kalpana na nyaya, it just doesn't make sense. Because when you say that is niravayava or partless, it means that he cannot be divided. And so to imagine jiva to be a division of paramatma, it is not right. Vipakshe doshamaha, vipakshe swataha deshasyabhi tasya samsari ekadesha kalpanayam. Suppose you insist that no, paramatma is a samsari and niravayava, but jiva is samsari and a part of paramatma. Suppose you insist upon that. So Anandagiri says, vipakshe doshamaha. In that kind of a vipaksha, this viparita paksha, viruddha paksha, dosham. So what is the defect involved? Bhashyakara said, adeshasya parasya ekadesha samsarita kalpanayam parhayava samsari iti kalpinam bhavet. Adeshasya niravayavasya. So paramatma who is niravayava, who is partless. Ekadesha samsarita kalpanayam, that of that jiva is a part and samsari, that kind of a kalpana. Parahaeva samsari iti kalpitam bhavet. Then it would amount to saying that paramatma himself is samsari, because when one part of him is samsari, naturally paramatma is samsari. All of this has been stated earlier, has been discussed. Therefore, it is just again being mentioned here that when paramatma is niravayavana samsari, to imagine jiva as an avayava of paramatma samsari doesn't make sense. Then Siddhanagi dvitiyam utthapayati aupadhikova ekadeshah. But then it is our experience, you see, if you just simply dismiss, saying that it is not possible, that is not nyaya, and that's how you dismiss this problem, that still it doesn't get dismissed from the mind. Because still it is my experience that I am a part, that I am separate from everything else, and I am a conscious being, all right, but a small little consciousness, endeavor, that I am a samsari, and that I am a part of the whole, that idea is very much embedded in me. So how do you explain that? The scheme of things that is presented, what we call the structure, or the prakriyas, you know, the whole model of the Vedanta that is presented, should be able to give an understanding of our entire life. So why do I feel the way I feel? If you say that I am not separate from Paramatma, Paramatma is my true nature, why do I feel only a part, and why do I feel divided? So what's your explanation for that? Most people believe that because I feel that I am a part, therefore I am a part. And because I feel that I am separate from everything else, therefore I am separate from everything else. Vedantin say, no, it's not necessary. Just because you feel does not mean that it has to be so. You can feel something which is not there. You can feel that there is a snake where in fact there is a rope, and therefore your feeling need not be given reality. So that very conclusion about myself is being questioned here. So dvitiyam utthapayati. That another explanation for the sense or the sense of duality that one experiences is that it may not be real, it may be aupadhika. That duality belonging someplace is superimposed upon there in one other place, and that's how the sense of duality could be felt. So athaiti, says Mahashaya.
Atha paropadikrataha ekadeshaha parasya ghatakarakadi akashavata. Atha paropadikrataha ekadeshaha parasya. Para means another. So, para upadhi, there is para or another para.
But it is upadhi krataha, brought about by upadhi. In the upadhi there is manyness, and because of that, and that manyness belonging to the upadhi is superimposed upon the paramatma, and therefore the idea of the manyness in paramatma comes. If suppose you imagine that, as we said, that just because the crystal appears red doesn't mean that it has to be red, because it could be due to the flower which is placed in the vicinity of a crystal which makes it appear red. So when something appears red, it can be because it is inherently has that color, or that somehow that color has come into it. Similarly also, that the multiplicity of the jivas is either inherent or paropadikrata. See footnote number 9. Kalpita upadikrata. Okay, put it that way. Kalpita upadikrata. That upadhi which is kalpita, and that is what brings about the idea of duality. Just as even in case of the sparks, it is the fire appears to be divided into sparks, because really it is the wooden particles that get split from the main wood or the log of wood rather. All those carbon particles are just split, and that creates the idea of splitting in fire. And similarly also, there is multiplicity someplace, no doubt, but not where we imagine it to be. That's all. So there is multiplicity or duality where in the upadhi. And that is confused, not confused to be, but superimposed upon the self. Ghatakarakadi akashavata. And so Bhashyakara gives example. Ghatakarakadi akashavata. Like the space which is undivided, and there is ghatakasha, karakakasha. So the pot space and the pitcher space and so forth and so on. So how the undivided space appears to be many because of the upadhi. Says Anandagiri, ekadeshasya aupadhikatva pakshe parasmin vivekavatam tat akhandatva buddhivajam tad ekadeshaha vastutaha prathak bhutva vyavaharalambanam iti naiva buddhihi jayate aupadhikasya sphatika lauhitavat mithyatvani uttaramaha. Uttar is stated right away. So, Sri Anandagiri, the answer is given how the division is upadhika. Ekadeshasya upadhikatva pakshe. That ekadeshatvam, being a part of Paramatma, is upadhikatva pakshe. That being a part, that whole idea is because of the upadhi. Meaning that the manyness belongs to the upadhi, which manyness is thought to be the manyness of the self. Parasmin vivekavatam tat akhandatva buddhivajam. So vivekavatam, those were the viveka, those were who discriminate between the real and the unreal, between the truth and the upadhi, between the true nature and the upadhi, those who are able to discriminate between the two. tat akhandatva buddhivajam. And because of that, so those who are able to see that the space is undivided, those who are able to discriminate between discriminate that the division in the space appears only because of the parsets and pans, and that space itself is undivided, and so akhandatva buddhivajam. Similarly also the consciousness is undivided. And then the idea of manyness comes because of the various upadis, the body and so forth. And so, as far as they are concerned, in consciousness they have akhandatva buddhi. Meaning that this is a viveka, that the duality belonging at the level of upadhi is not superimposed upon the consciousness, that in spite of this duality, consciousness is undivided and non-dual. So, tad akhandatva buddhi vajam, tad ekadeshah vastutah prithak bhutva vyavahar alambanaviri naiva buddhi jayate. And therefore, for this discriminative people, this kind of a notion that the Atma has really separated or split from Brahma, and then, so that kind of a separation never becomes a part of their vyavahara, buddhi. So vyavahara alamanam idaneva buddhi jayate. And that, this is the real division, that kind of buddhi never arises in them. Aupadikasya sphatika lavitya vyat mithyatvat. Just as sphatika or the crystal appears to be red, and that redness of the crystal is mithya, and so also the divisions appearing in consciousness is mithya. Iti uttaramaha, that's the answer that Bhashyakara gives, natadayati. So says Bhashyakara, natada tatra vivekina paramatmaika deshah prasak samvyavahar bhak iti buddhi utpadyate. Natada ekadeshasya aupadhikattva avasare. When you accept that ekadeshatvam or the idea of manyness is due to upadhi, tatra means parasmin tadabhinne vijnanatmani viyavat. So for those who understand, who can see that the manyness is upadhika due to upadhi, for them in the paramatma or even in the jivatma also, vivekinam paramatma ekadesha, that is jivatma is ekadesha or a part of paramatma, prithak samvyavahar bhag janam idi vyavahar vishaya prithak samvyavahar bhag. Vyavahara is shabda prayoga, to use a certain expression is called vyavahara. That prithak samvyavahar bhag, therefore that is something separate, you know, iti buddhi na utpadyate. In fact this na, there should not be this. So na utpadyate, nakara goes with na utpadyate. It is not an answer to something like that, you know. It is actually an explanation of what is said earlier. Yada asamin shada antada. And so in the vivekis, this kind of buddhi or this, the idea of duality does not arise. Then says Anandagiri, nanu jive kartaham bhoktaham idi parichinnadehi sarvesham upalabhyade. Nanu jive, with reference to jiva, kartaham bhoktaham, I am a doer, I am an enjoyer, idi parichinnadehi sarvesham upalabhyade. Sarvesham means viveka avivekavatam. We find that even wise people also, they also seem to entertain the idea that I am doing something, I am enjoying something. So kartrutva, bhoktrutva appears to be there even in wise people too, as it appears in the other wise people. Sacha is what? Parichinna dhihi. Parichinna dhihi means the idea that I am parichinna, idea that I am limited. That karta, bhokta is a sense of limitation seems to be there in the viveki as well as aviveki. So in the discriminating and non-discriminating equally. Sachatasya vastutah aparichin brahma matratvat mancha kroshan dhivat upacharita. Now when the technical point is being made here, that alright, you say that the vivekis do not give reality to the sense of division, but we say that the sense of division is figurative, in a secondary sense. If there is no primary division, the secondary division is there in some ways.
साच तस्य तस्य जीवस्य वस्तुतः अपरिच्छिन्न ब्रह्मात्मत्वात्
वस्तुतः वी एक्सेप्ट दैट जीवा इज वस्तुतः इन रियलिटी अपरिच्छिन्न ब्रह्मात्मत्वात् दैट इज ब्रह्मन् दैट जीवा इन रियलिटी इज ब्रह्मन् दैट इज अनडिवाइडेड एंड देयरफॉर दैट आइडिया ऑफ द ड्युअलिटी इज नॉट रियल वी एक्सेप्ट दैट एंड स्टिल देयर इज अ डिफरेंस मेड बिटवीन मिथ्यात्वम एंड गौणत्वम So there is called, there is one Gauni Vritti or there is Mithya Vritti. Mithya means unreal. Gauni means secondary. It says, Mancha Kroshan Dhivat. This Mancha Kroshan, Mancha Kroshan Dhi. The scaffoldings are shouting. Thus these are the days actually. When in the morning you find this farmer is going to the field early morning and shouting and screaming to scare away the birds. Because now the birds come and they eat away all this crop, you know. So those people have made scaffoldings for them. And you will find this scaffolding in every field. All of them shouting together. And so you don't see the people inside these scaffoldings. Then you say, Manchaha Kroshanti. The scaffoldings are shouting. That's a figurative way of saying. The scaffoldings are not shouting. And therefore to say that the scaffolding is shouting is wrong. Okay, we accept that. But it is Upacharita. Upacharita is what? It is said in the secondary sense. In fact, the shouting happens in the people who are sitting in the scaffolding, but that is superimposed upon the mancha or the scaffolding, and then we say that the scaffolding is shouting. However, there is a difference there, that actually there are some people shouting. In fact, shouting is there, and that real shouting alone is imagined to be elsewhere. And so shouting is real someplace. Similarly also if you say that there is some place a real division, which is even though manchas are not shouting, scaffoldings are not shouting, but people are really shouting. Even though similarly the jiva is not divided in reality, somewhere the real division is there, which real division is imagined to be in jiva. So somewhere the real division is there, that point is being made.
Mancha kroshana divat upacharita. See footnote number 5, upacharita adi. Upachara hai, guna hai, tat prayukta. So like Simho Devadatta hai, we say. Simho Devadatta hai. The Devadatta is a lion. It's not in a primary sense. But it's not mithya also. Mithya is that something that is totally apparent. At least Devadatta has some quality of lion. At least it belongs to Lion's Club or something like these days. Anyway, that way we guess. Otherwise, in the olden days when this was not there, you can say that Devadatta has some kind of a quality, maybe fearlessness or what, or aggressiveness or cruelty or something that Devadatta has. Usually we use the word lion and tiger to praise somebody. So he's a fearlessness, you know. So Devadatta possesses fearlessness of a lion and so you call him lion. But then he's not lion in primary sense, but he does possess a guna, with one quality of lion. So this is called Gauni Vritti, which is based on guna or quality. So says footnote of 5, Upacharita Ivi. Upacharaha Gunaha. Tat Prayukta Gauni. So some kind of guna or quality is there, which quality. So some similarity is there between Devadatta and Lion. Some similarity is there. Nadu Mithya Bhuta. That lionness of the Devadatta is not totally wrong, or totally in non-existent. Part of it is existent and therefore it is used in a gauna or a secondary sense.
Iti avada. So prakrute antahkaranadi upadhi samsarga eva guno dastavya. So here the imagination of the purupakshi is that antahkaranas or the upadhis are many. And that atma has a real contact with his antahkarana. That a real division obtains in the upadhi. And that Atma has a real contact with Upadhi. And that is why we have the Upachara of taking Atma to be many. Like imagining that the crystal has a real contact with the flower. And therefore, the redness has come into the crystal in some ways because of the contact. Similarly also, that the Jiva, the Atma or its consciousness has a real contact with Upadhi. And therefore, the divisions obtaining the Upadhi are said to be obtaining in the Atma.
प्रकृते अंतःकरणादि उपाधि संसर्ग एव गुणो द्रष्टव्यः
सो हियर we have to say that the upadhi is like antahkarana, etc. Samsargaha, that atma is samsargaha, a contact with that. And that is how, therefore the divisions belonging to antahkarana, which is connected to atma, is thought to be in the atma. Says manchakroshana manchakroshana dhyamtu kroshana kartru pum samsargah sah. Whereas manchakroshana dhyam, so people who believe that manchaha kroshanti, the scaffolding, the shouting, for them kroshana kartru pum samsargah sah, that the manchaha kroshanti, the scaffolding, the shouting, is because there is a real contact, the scaffolding there with the people who are really shouting. So people are shouting and the scaffolding is a real contact with them. That's how we say that the scaffolding is shouting. Similarly also, there is a division of upadhi, and that the upadhi has a real contact with the atma. Therefore we say that the atma is divided. Even though atma is not divided, but at least it has a contact with upadhi, that is divided. And that is how we feel that the idea of kartaham, bhoktaham is there. So we find that even the vivekis are discriminating people also, the idea of I am a doer or I am an enjoyer seem to persist. So says Anandagirino, sācha tasya vastutah aparichinna brahmātratvāt, that we accept that jīva is in fact Brahman with aparichinnam, limitless. Mancha kroshana dhivat upacharita, the parichinna dhihi, kartaham, bhoktaham, that parichinnatva dhihi, that I am a limited being, that comes because the limitation belongs to the upadhi, and therefore because the contact with the upadhi, he doesn't superimpose limitation. The difference that the limitation belonging to upadhi being superimposed is purely due to ignorance. But limitation belonging to upadhi is due to contact with upadhi, there is some reality in that. So if you can see the difference here, that one feels a sense of limitation. What Vedantins will say is, that is pure, totally false. And that's a limitation belonging to one place. Like the body is superimposed upon the atma, so even when the limitation is superimposed, atma remains free from limitation. Here they say that the atma, the consciousness, has contact with upadhi, and therefore the duality belonging to upadhi is thought to be in the atma, but some kind of a contact is there. So says Anandi, tasmat uvayesham uktatma buddhi darshanat paramatma ekadeshatvam jivasya durvaram iti chodayati. Tasmat, therefore, uvayesham viveka aviveka vatam, both the wise and the otherwise people, uktatma buddhi darshanat parichinnadhi darshanat. So you find that the wise people also seem to entertain the idea of us unlimited ahankara, and of course the ignorant people entertain that. Paramatma ekadeshatvam jivasya iti durvaram, so jivasya durvaram iti chodayati. Never. In some other way he wants to prove that jiva is ekadesha or a part of paramatma, because we find that sense of limitation there even in the people who are discriminating people. Therefore we say that somehow the division belonging to the upadhi touches this paramatma, and that is how in some way he becomes a sort of a part of paramatma, he becomes limited. See footnote number 8 says paramatma ekadeshatvam jivasya iti uktadhi vishayatvam eva jivatvam. What is jivatvam? Uktadhi vishayatvam, that parichinnadhi vishayatvam, that I am parichinna, I am limited. Tachya parichinna eva nato parichinna brahmani iti, and that sense of limitation belongs only to jiva and not to Brahma. Iti paraikadeshasya eva jivatvam anubhavikam iti bhavaha. What we say it is, if you say that jiva is a part of paramatma, then if jiva is samsari, paramatma also becomes samsari. That part is answering. The samsaritvam belongs only to jiva but not to paramatma, because jiva takes it upon himself. Because of the contact that the jiva has with the upadhi, he takes himself to be limited, and therefore samsaritvam is what? Be having a sense of limitation, and that belongs only to jiva because of the contact with upadhi and does not belong to paramatma. Therefore Your insistence that if you imagine Jiva to be samsari, Paramatma also becomes samsari, need not be, when that samsaritam is aupacharikam. So samsaritam of Jiva is not mithya, but aupacharikam. It's not real. We say that samsaritam of the Jiva is not real, we accept. But mithya means not there. We say that samsaritam is never there. He says, no, samsaritam is aupacharikam. What belongs, real samsaritam that belongs in one place, some guna or some similarity is there, and therefore Jiva has that kind of samsaritam of parichinnata, so kartaham bhoktaham. But then, since aupacharikam samsaritam, therefore that samsaritam does not come to Paramatma. This is the technical way of explaining how it is aupacharikam. Samsaritam is aupacharikam in the secondary sense, even though it is not in the primary sense. But we want to prove that it is mithya, it is not there at all. So anyway, that is avivekinam. This question is asked here in the Bhashya. Avivekinam, vivekinam cha, upacharita buddhi, drishta iti che. Avivekinam, vivekinam cha, both the discriminating as well as non-discriminating for them, upacharita buddhi drishta. That buddhi means parichinna buddhi, parichinnatva buddhi. We find the sense of limitation being entertained by both. And that is upacharita, and that is in a secondary sense. This is what we find. So is Anandagiri tatra avivekina yasokta buddhi upacharita anubhavati. Atasmin tad buddhitvena avidyatvami pariharati. We say, no, no, tatra ubhayo atmaniva. Tatra means what? Between vivekis and avivekis. Or tatra means with reference to atma. Avivekinam yathokta buddhi upacharita na bhavati. For aviveki or non-discriminating people, when an ignorant person says, I am a jiva or I am a samsari or I am karta bhokta, he means it. He is not upacharita. For an ignorant person, that buddhi, the sense of limitation, is real. Atasmin tad buddhitvena avidyatvat. Atasmin tad buddhi. What is atat? Upon that, the tad buddhi. Atasmin tad buddhi. So, what is undivided? In that, the sense of division is called atasmin tad buddhi. Buddhitvena avidyatvadi pariharati mithyatvadi avat. Therefore, in case of an ignorant person, it is ignorant person takes it to be real. Even though the way the sense of limitation arises in ignorant person is because the limitation belonging to one, namely upadhi, is superimposed upon the atma. So it is upadhi to be atma. Atasmin tad buddhi. What is not atma is taken to be atma. So that is atasmin tad buddhi. And therefore, it is not that what Bhashyakara wants to say is that both vivekis and avivekis say that I am karta bhokta hamiti. But when aviveki says that, he means it. And when viveki says, he just says it as a matter of role. In case of viveki, the wise person, even though for the sake of vyavahara, he does use the expressions I, you, etc. But then, all that is merely for vyavahara and not in reality. In case of aviveki, it is reality. But nowhere there is upachara. In aviveki, it is mithya. In the wise man, it is merely a play. For the wise man, this aham, mama, etc. or kartrutva, bhoktrutva is merely a matter of play. In case of the ignorant person, it is mithya. So this parichinnatvadhihi, that a sense of limitation is not avacharika, it is mithya. So Vashyakara said, na avivekinam mithya buddhitvat. So avivekis are actually superimposing what belongs to one on the other one, and therefore it is mithya. That's the definition of mithya. Tasmin tad buddhi. Then say Ranagiri, tathabhi vivekinam idrushi dihi upacharita chet iti chet. Tathabhi aviveki dihi mithya. All right. With reference to ignorant people, it is mithya. Imagine. And then wise people it is upacharita. How can it be? So even when the ignorant people have that these mithya, why not we imagine that a wise man, he is a wise man, he is upacharita, meaning in a secondary sense.
Tatraha vivekinam chaiti, says Vashyakara. Vivekinam cha samvyavahara matra alambra tattvat.
So, vivekinam cha, in case of aviveki, it is mithya. In case of viveki, it is merely just a matter of vyavahara or shabda prayoga, that there is no reality at all in that. Samvyavahara matra alambra tattvat is explained in footnote number 2. Samvyavahara iti karta bhoktaha mityadi rupasya samvyavahara matrasya. Vyavahara is shabda prayoga. Kartaham, bhoktaham, I am a doer, I am an enjoyer. Ityadi rupasya samvyavahara matrasya alambram swanishta kartatvad rupah mithyabhutah vishayartha yasyaha viveka buddhehe. So in case of wise man, even when he uses the expression I am doing this, or I am eating this, or I am enjoying this, in fact that mithyatma nishchaya is there, and therefore there is no superimposition involved, and that is being done merely as a matter of vyavahara, because otherwise there will be total confusion, you know. So some people say this is going and this is coming and things like that, you know. So they don't use the word I, that I am going and I am coming, which is right also. This is going, this came, this went. It all looks good with Ramana Maharshi, you know. That all always look good, all right, somehow, no problem. But then, when every Tom, Dick and Harry start saying that this went and this came, it becomes, you know, the Swami sometimes call it all this spiritual snobbishness, you know. So look, people then say this went and this came, etc. What it means is I went and I came, and still that, but somehow it is felt that by using this kind of expressions, you know, well, it can help in a way. To say that this, it can help also. But it can create a tremendous amount of confusion, you know, when you are interacting with the people. And therefore, wise people use this I, etc., mine or whatever, in order for the convenience of interacting with the world, rather than because it is real or it is even a secondary for them.
So, samvyavahara matra alambanartatvat.
Samvyavahara matra, merely samvyavahara, merely interaction with people, that alambaram, so that they have this buddhi, the aham karta, aham bhokta, has its content merely, has a purpose merely for the purpose of vyavahara or interaction, that's all.
Says Anandi, tesham samvyavahara abhijnya abhivadanatmaka. Abhijna abhivadanam. Abhijna. So samvyavahara means shabda prayoga. As footnote number 12 says, jnana shabda prayoga atmaka. Vyavahara means to use a certain shabda prayoga. Tesham samvyavahara abhijna abhivadanatmaka. Of the purpose of saying, karta bhokta, saying this. Tavan matrasya arambaram. Abhasabhutah arthah, in fact, he explains that asamyavahara matra alambana arthatvat tavan matrasya alambanam abhasabhutah arthah. It is merely an abhasa, meaning it is apparently, so they just use the word karta, like an actor who acts as a beggar or a king, knowing fully well that is not so, and so also a wise man, for the purpose of interacting with the world, seems to wear the garb of kartrutva, bhoktrutva and whatever, knowing fully well that that is not really the nature of the self. Abhasabhutam is mithyabhutah. So mithyabhutah artha tad vishayatva tad buddhyapi. And therefore, that buddhi or the idea, the notion that I am karta, I am bhokta, since that kartrutva, bhoktrutva ideas have been simply adopted for the sake of interacting, and therefore that awareness is there in the buddhi, that I am saying, that I am going and I am coming, it is mainly for the purpose of vyavahara or interaction, rather than it being real. Tad buddhi api mithya buddhitvat. And therefore,
even that notion also is mithya and not aupacharika.
Upacharitva asiddhi, asiddhi ityartha, therefore,
the upacharitvatvam is not there and there is what is mithyatvam. There is that fine difference between aupacharika buddhi and mithyatva buddhi.
That is further explained. Vivekanam, avivekanam cha atmani parichinnadihi upalabdhe upalabdha iti etavada natasya vastuta brahmam shatvadi siddhyati tetat dushtantena sadhayati. Vivekanam, avivekanam cha. So, for the wise and the otherwise, atmani parichinnadihi upalabdha. They seem to exhibit a sense of liberation about themselves, both the ignorant and the wise. Just because of that, just because you find someone, you know, using this expression that I am doing this and I am going, etc., when the expressions are used, natasya vastuta brahmam shatvadi siddhyati. Because of that, tasya jivasya paramarthikam brahmam shatvadi na siddhyati. Just because somebody says that I am karta mukta, that itself is not enough to establish that he is necessarily a part of Brahman or that he is really a karta or bhokta. Idhita drishtandina sadhayati, the Bhashyakara establishes that by drishtand or illustration, yathayati. Vashya yatha krishna raktascha akasha iti vivekinam api kadachita krishnata raktadacha akashasya samyavahar namatra lumbanarthatvam pratipadyate iti na paramarthatah krishno raktova akashah bhavitumarhati. Yatha krishnah raktascha akashah space. What akasha is both in neuter as well as in masculine. So akasha krishnah black, so darks, you know, the sky is dark. Or rakta, as we see in the evening, becomes red. Iti vivekinam api kadachit krishnata raktata cha akashasya samyavahara matra lambana sattvam pratipadyate. Vivekinam, the discriminating people who know that the space does not have any color, does not have any form, doesn't, you know, space doesn't have any space in the sense that there is no color, no form, no, you know, it is formless, colorless, is known to them. And even then, kadachit, sometimes we find them using the expressions rakushnada raktada cha akashasya. Hey, the space is dark, the space is red, the sky is red, etc. samvyavahara matra alambana sattvam pratipadyate. So for them, samvyavahara matra alambana sattvam mithya vishayatvam pratipadyate. They say this merely for the purpose of vyavahara, merely for the purpose of interaction. Na paramarthatah krishno ruttova akasho bhavitum arhati. That akasha is in reality red or black, it is not so. Knowing this fully well, still we find even the people who are knowledgeable using the expression that the akasha is red or whatever. Now the latest wisdom is there is no such thing as gravity. You know, latest means already 75 years old, I think. But then this gravity, etc., you know, is also not there. What there is there's a huge mass like sun that creates a certain field around itself, and therefore other bodies like earth, that's they travel around that. So this orbit is decided really by that mass obtaining in the sun and the mass obtaining in the earth. And it is because of that phenomenon that the particles fall and stuff like that, you know. And so it is again all a part of relativity and this mass energy conversion, etc. So gravity is fine, tentatively is fine,
But in the fine thinking, even that kind of an idea of gravity, etc., also now is replaced by finer ideas. So a scientist may know this, but when he talks to us, he will still use the word gravity and things like that. For the knowing that this is what people would understand, and that then it's not wrong in any sense, in the sense that it is all right in order to communicate or in order to interact with the people. And so wise people also continue to use the conventional expressions, because otherwise, you know, how will you can communicate? And you cannot interact. For interaction and communication, they continue to use the conventional expressions. But then all this mithyatva dhihi, the sense of limitation, is mithya for them. So vivekanam api siddhanagari avivekanam iva iti apeheyartha. Like the ignorant people also, the scientists also may say blue sky and stuff like that, but that is merely just to have a conversation or something like that, you know, or to be able to communicate. Brahmani vastutah am shadi kalpana na kartavyayati dashtantikam upasamharati. Brahmani vastutah am shadi kalpana na kartavyayati. Therefore, one should not have this imagination that Brahma is divided into parts or Brahma is divisible. This kind of a kalpana is not necessary. Without that kalpana also, the whole vyavahara can be explained very neatly. The idea of mithyatvam is a fantastic idea, that something can appear to be there and not really there. This never occurred to anybody, you know. The thing is that something can be there, appear to be there, real, and need not be there at all. And so the snake can appear to be there, very real, and need not be there at all. And similarly, the division may appear to be there. All strife and struggle and sadness may appear to be there and need not be there. That is, there should be no reason for it anyway. Need not be there means what? There need not be a reason for it, because there is no cause for it. The sadness comes because of the division, duality and stuff like that. And that is given reality. That's why all these further things are created, alright. But just because something appears to be there doesn't mean it has to be there. This is the idea. This is mithyatvam. And therefore, when that way we can explain and understand the whole vyavahara, why should we imagine the real division? The point is that the multiplicity of the Atma, etc., is projected by Sankhyas and others. Because how else will you explain the vyavahara of my feeling separate from someone else? And if Atma is one, they say that everybody should be born together, and everybody should die together, everybody should be happy together, everybody should be unhappy together. Otherwise, how can Atma be one? And we find that somebody has interest in literature, somebody has interest in Bhagavad Gita, somebody has interest in Vairagya, somebody wants to accumulate, somebody is devoted to knowledge, somebody is devoted to bhoga. All these differences are there. Then we also find some people are sattvic, others are rajas, some are tamas, all of this stuff is there. So all these divisions and varieties, how can we explain? Therefore we say that Atmas are many. Having said Atmas are many, they still want to say that Atma is ever unaffected by that. Because they retract from that position of manyness. Manyness would imply limitation and impurity that they don't want. So the thing is that everybody finds difficulties with acceptance of manyness. But the obligation to explain the experience is so much there. They feel that they are obliged to explain the experience, and that requires them to accept these ideas of division, etc. He says the obligation of explaining the vyavahara or experiences can be easily fulfilled by the idea of mithyatvam. What is mithyatvam? Atasmin tad buddhihi, superimposition, adhyasa. What belongs in one place is superimposed upon the other. What belongs to Antahkarana, superimposed upon the self. This is mithyatvam. Not being, not really there, and seeing it to be real. When that explains, then why should you have to imagine the Atma is really sad? There is no that kalpana na kartavya. You should not have that kalpana. It is darshtantikam upasamharati. Bhashyakara says it to me. Normally they would not say that. They would leave all these kind of conclusions to us. Sometimes they don't do that, you know. Because he feels a tremendous amount of urgency and need and emphasis. Therefore it is said, Brahmani vastutah am shadi kalpana na kartavya. just because we see a pot space and a room space and stuff like that, that doesn't mean that we have to imagine that the space is really pot space and room space. The space is divided. There's no need to be able to understand the divisions obtaining in the spaces in different parts. There's no need to project that duality or multiplicity in the space itself. Knowing well, fully well that or understanding that, the idea of the division comes not because there is a real division, but the division obtains only in the walls of the pot, and that division is superimposed upon the space, and we feel that the spaces are many. So just because spaces appear to be many does not mean that you imagine the manyness in the space. Don't do that. So, Ataha, page 504. अतः न पंडितैः ब्रह्मस्वरूप प्रतिपत्ति विषये ब्रह्मणः अंश अंशे एकदेश देश एक एकदेशी या लेट्स व्हाट इट इज एकदेश एकदेशी विकार विकारित्व कल्पना कार्य सर्वकल्पना अपनयार्थ अपनयार्थ सार परत्वात् सर्वोपनिषदम् अतः देयरफॉर अतः इज फुटनोट 1 वक्ष्यमाणात् So we already said, and again, the reason what is going to be stated because of that, panditai, at least by the wise people, by the learned, by the people of pure mind, people who need not insist upon blasphemizing Brahman by calling it divided, or imagining, you know, or blasphemizing even the self, thinking that it is really a limited one, there is no need. That blasphemy need not be performed by the people of pure mind. Panditehi Brahma Swarupa Pratipatti Vishaye. This is footnote number 2. Brahma Swarupa Pratipatti Prayojane Shruti Vakye, with reference to Shruti Vakye. So the passages of Shruti which are intended for delineating or explaining the Swarupa, the true nature of Brahman, Yadva Brahma Swarupa Pratipatti Vishaye Vijnanatmani, or the Jivatma which is thought, which is sought to be understood or which is sought to be revealed as Brahman with reference to Brahma or Jiva. So don't see this idea of duality in Shruti. Just because Shruti gives the illustration of fire and the sparks, do not imagine that the Shruti means that the sparks are different from fire or the Jivas are different from Brahman. So don't read those things in the Shruti passages. Or just because you experience a sense of limitation, therefore don't see that you are divided from Brahman. So neither the illustration from the Shruti, neither should that give you the idea of division, nor your experience of limitation should actually give you the idea of division. You should not take that to be that way. So it was explained how the Shruti statements are to understood as in one aspect of the illustration as to how the spark was fired before its separation or splitting from the fire. So that is amsha, the aspect of the standard illustration that is applicable there, and not what happens after the spark is split from the fire, but what of spark before the fire. That is where, that is the aspect of illustration, and that the sense of limitation that obtains the jiva is upadhika and not real, nor it is aupacharika. Having explained both ways, panditehi brahmasvarupa pratipatti vishaye brahmanah amshamshi, brahma is amshi and atma is amsha, ekadesha ekadeshi, atma is ekadesha part and brahma is whole, vikara vikari, that jiva is vikara or jagat is vikara and brahman is vikari, that which underwent vikara. Kalpana na karya, this kind of kalpana should not be done by the wise or discriminating people. Says Anandagiri, amshamshinoho vishadi karanam ekadesha ekadeshi. So amshamshin meaning ekadesha ekadeshi, part and whole. Or the modification, mutation, and the cause of mutation. Atah, therefore, atah shabdopatthamam hetum sphute, therefore comes later. The reason for therefore comes later here. That's why I said, vakshamanat. So atah shabdopatthamam eva hetum sphute, therefore means certain reason is there. The reason is given by Bhashyakara later. Sarva kalpana apanayarth apanayanarth sarparatvat sarvopanishadam. Sarvopanishadam paratvat. All the Upanishads are committed to only one thing. Sarva kalpana apanayana. To eliminate or remove all the kalpanas, all these imaginations and notions about Brahman is the purpose of all the Upanishads. Sarva kalpana apanayanarth sarparatvat. Says Anandagiri, sarvasam kalpananam apanayanam eva arthah. So sarvasam kalpanam apanayanam. Apanayanam is what? Nibbutti. In fact, all the kalpanas a fellow is born with, that itself is creation. Nivrutti. To actually bring a cessation of all the, to release this person. To release this person from the bondage of kalpana. That the bondage is purely kalpana. And all the kalpanas, a tremendous light. Silkworm. So how it creates a whole cocoon around itself, so also this poor jiva has created a tremendous cocoon of all these kalpanas and notions and complexes around itself, and that itself is a bondage. And so kalpana apanayana vevartha, to release him, if the release had to be accomplished in a real sense, then that's a different thing. But here the release is merely release from all these kalpanas and notions. And that's all the Upanishad, that is what Upanishad is committed to, is to remove every kalpana. Not a single kalpana should be left. So, tadeva arthaha. Arthaha is what? Prayojanam. That's the purpose of all the Upanishads. Saratvena abhishtaha. That prayojan of the purpose, to release the jiva from all the kalpana of the notions, is the sara, is the very, so, abhishtam. That is what is desired by the Upanishad. Saratvena abhishtaha. That prayojan of the purpose alone is desired by the Upanishad as the very essence of the teaching. And so all description of creation and this and that, all these stories, ultimately purpose is what? That the student gives reality to the creation, to release his mind from that idea that the creation is real. Or do you think that the creation is not Brahman? Release his mind from that. Or do you think that creation is independent? Again, to release his mind from those ideas, that even the description of creation is given. So what is the purpose that you should say? What for a given thing is said? So don't take it in the manner in which it is meant. What is meant is to remove the kalpanas and not create. Already the fellow is born with all kinds of kalpanas. What's the point in it?